Okay, full disclosure, this is my third attempt because I keep making mistakes, either with the video or with the actual problem. So this is the Relative Dating Lab number one. And before we start diving into it, let's just look at an overview. You see a lot of horizontal or formerly horizontal layers of sedimentary rock. You see some that are tilted more steeply than others. You see some erosional boundaries between them, an angular unconformity. All you need to know is that means erosion. We see another one here. This one's hard to see. People always miss it. But there's erosion between the pink and the orange. And here, this is a little bit easier to see. You see this line between the purple and the yellow. You might not notice that that's erosion, but it becomes obvious right here because it's chopped off the top of that red. Okay, and then we've got some more here with this youngest layer up here. Okay, so let's read these directions and make sure we know what we're doing so we don't make the same mistake I did. All right, so we're going to determine the relative sequence of the events in the diagram below. Enter the letter of the rock unit or the geologic structure in the proper event sequence. The geologic events of tilting, folding, and erosion do not have single letter labels. Type the word tilting, folding, or erosion in the proper position. Event number one is the oldest event. You'll notice that event number one is way down here, because what have we learned? That the oldest things are at the bottom of the sequence, okay, and the youngest are at the top. Okay, so let's figure this out. I'm going to show you how to do this. It tells you to go through the whole thing and grade it. Don't do that. Let's first by do this like two at a time, and then we'll check our work and we'll inch our way through it. I'll let you go on your own after about, I don't know, five or six. So look at this orange igneous rock here. Notice it has the same symbol as this red stuff, but they're different rocks based on the color. So this is the older one because it's at the bottom of all this sequence. This one over here we know isn't the oldest, and a lot of people think it is, but it's not. It overcuts. It's on top of these other things in here. It's intruded into them. So it must be younger than these. Okay? I'm giving a lot away here. But let's go with this oldest layer over here is E. So we type in E. And then what happens after E? And everybody wants to jump on G. Yeah, let's go with that. No. There is a erosional thing here. And it's nonconformity, but in this lesson, all you call it is erosion. Okay? Because it says so right here in the instructions. Got to write the word erosion. Right there it is. All right, now let's check our work. Yay, we got a lot wrong. But the things we have wrong haven't been done yet. But one and two are correct because they don't show up. So we move forward. So, what comes after erosion? G. Then what? You said L. Yes, you're right. And then what happens after L? C. Okay. All right, now what? Here's where I screwed up. All right, what? Gotta remind myself. How are all rocks originally deposited? They're deposited horizontally. Are these rocks horizontal anymore? No. So, something happened. And you might say, hey, but they've also been broken, Miss Fruis. Look at this. There's a line cutting right through it. There's a fault H right through all of it. And notice that the fault is eroded off too. So what happened here? There's a bunch that's easy to get lost here. Well, just generally, it's usually true that rocks tilt, get bent, get folded before they break. You know, you grab a stick, you bend it before it breaks. Okay? So these rocks probably got folded or tilted. We'll call it tilting because they're not really folded, they're just tilted. Let's see if this is right. Yay! It is. And after it was tilted, then what happened to it? I gotta hit OK here. And after it was tilted, what do you think probably happened? It broke. Let's check it out. Oops, I almost did it again. I'm trying to type in the word fault, but that's not one of the words you type in. If you look in the instructions, you won't find it. You'll find folding, but you won't find faulting. The fault has a label H. So let's try that. Let's see if this is right. Yes. Okay. I'm not going to show you anymore. That was a lot of help. But I want you to get through this. And it's easy to go through it by just clicking on grade sequence as you go. Okay? You get the idea.